escorted to the turf rather rudely by Shaw Cross.
I don't even know if that's legal in the NFL.
Yeah, no.
Defensive player. You're getting fined and ejected. Bye. You can't do that.
Welcome to It's a Replay presented by Cheese and Andrew Wiebe, Charlie Davies. Charlie, you ready?
Always ready.
It was a chippy one in the nation's capital, D.C. Inter Miami. Fast forward to the 84th minute, and here's Ryan Shawcross going in, throwing down, getting the red card from referee Fotis Bouzakos. Charlie, give me your take. Is this violent conduct?
I don't believe it was a red card. Violent conduct is when a player uses or attempts to use excessive force or brutality against an opponent when not challenging for the ball. I don't believe this was excessive force. Yes, it comes down to frustration. Yes, they were going to lose the game. And yes, he deserved a card, although it should have been yellow in my opinion.
Charlie, we always talk about this. We look for reactions from the player after calls like this. Is Ryan Shawcross upset?
No.
He is not. Check his body language. I think he knows why. It's because he grabs, he doesn't slow down, and he pulls and throws Mora down, even if we can debate the force on that one. In my mind, though, it is excessive force. That makes it violent conduct. Good red card.
I think the body language is a result of the team's performance rather than the play.
Rewind, back to the 71st minute. Christian McCoon in the penalty area. He's defending. He's handling the ball as his arm flails behind him. And that is a penalty kick, says Fotis Bouzakos. It's checked by VAR Alejandro Mariscal, and they say, yes, keep it as a PK, and I absolutely agree. This is bang-bang, but the arm is clearly away from the body, and I think ultimately he is making himself bigger. It might be harsh if you're a defender, but ultimately you understand. Your arm is swinging wildly, it's outside the body, and you stop a shot on goal. Good call. How about this, though, Charlie? 20th minute, LA Seattle. Jao Paulo bumps Chicharito, and is that a PK?
Clever, 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 Chicharito. Now, I see Jao Paulo make contact, and like any savvy striker, goes down, and you're not overturning this call because there is contact, and it has to be clear and obvious for it to not be a penalty. So, yes, the call was right. It's a smart play by Chicharito. I think they got this one right. And Wiebe, what about this play that took place in the FC Dallas versus Minnesota match? It's the 84th minute, and Ricardo Pepi avoids a red card throwing this elbow right at Emmanuel Reynoso. Was he lucky to not be sent off?
All right, Charlie, let's start with the rule on violent conduct. The player who, when not challenging for the ball, deliberately strikes an opponent or any other person on the head or face with the hand or arm is guilty of violent conduct unless the force used was negligible. So two questions. First, did Pepi deliberately strike Reynoso in the head or face? And second, was the force excessive or was it indeed negligible? I think Marcos de Oliveira got this one exactly right, and he even went back to the monitor to look at it a second time after VAR Kevin Stott flagged him. I think Pepi is trying to just get a piece, a bump, a push on Reynoso in the upper chest, and just glancingly misses and gets a little bit of the chin.
Wiebe, you've never been so right. And you also have to throw in the Meg. The Meg is what initiated that elbow.
NYCFC versus New England, and Charlie already gave your take on this one. It's the 10th minute. Jesus Medina is motored into the box, and Andrew Farrell takes him down. PK says referee Alan Chapman, and I agree. There's not a ton of contact here, but there from that back angle, you can see where Farrell. It's a little piece of Jesus Medina, and he goes down, and yes, there's embellishment, but it's also a foul. Good call. How about this one, though? Atlanta Philly, Charlie. Deep in first half stoppage time, Anthony Fontana gets bumped. He goes down. Is that a penalty kick?
It's not a penalty for me. There's not enough contact for me to warrant a penalty. So I think the referee did a good job with no call here.
I agree. Ted Uncle got this one right. More of a 50-50 to me than it is anything else. How about this one, though? 63rd minute, Eric Lopez meet Kai Wagner. That sure looks like a penalty to me, Charlie.
My, oh my, Wiebe. In my opinion, Ted Uncle missed this penalty call. Kai Wagner comes in reckless, doesn't make contact with the ball, and instead catches Lopez inside the box. This was a penalty.
That's a PK for me as well, Charlie. Let's finish it off. Toronto, Orlando, 34th minute. Omar Gonzalez wants this PK call. There is a little bit of hug there from Robin Johnson. What do you think?
Yeah, there was a little bit of, but not a penalty. For me, there wasn't enough to warrant a penalty. This is Omar Gonzalez. It's going to take a lot more to bring him down.
Oh, you got that right, Charlie. Omar's never getting to this ball, and he's a big boy. He could have stayed up. That's it from us. If you see something, say something. Hit us up on Twitter or get us in the comments section. We'll see you next time.